Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, we will understand one of the important concepts which is many times asked in the interviews of the companies like Qualcomm, NXP, Samsung, Harman. We will understand what is little endian and what is big endian and how it matters. That is, what is the significance of these terms? I will also explain this concept practically with the help of a C code. So let's start. Now, before moving to little endian and big endian, let's understand what is the meaning of endianness. So endianness actually means how your data will be stored inside the memory if your data is larger than 1 byte. Say if your data is, let's say, 2 byte, 4 byte, then what will be the arrangement or the format of the data which will be going inside the memory for the storage. So endianness tells me the ordering of the bytes. So little endian and big endian are two such formats which tells me that how my data or how the bytes of our data will be stored inside our memory. So little endian and big endian tells me the byte order or the alignment of my bytes inside the memory. So as you can see in the diagram, here it is your CPU and here it is your memory. Now in your programming, let's say C, you have char data, you have int data also. So char data is of 8 bit, that is 1 byte. Then you have short int is of 16 bit, that is 2 byte, and int is of 32 bit, that is 4 byte. So 8 bit, 16 bit, 32 bit, every data can be transferred via this 32 bit data bus. So when we say that our system is little endian or big endian, it means our CPU is little endian based or big endian based. But the arrangement of the data we are talking about, it is in the memory. So we are storing the data inside the memory according to this CPU. But when we are storing the data, we are storing the data inside the memory. So the data will be stored inside the memory either in the little endian or big endian format depending on our CPU. If our CPU is little endian based, then data will be stored in that alignment form. If our CPU is big endian based, then the data will be stored in big endian format inside our memory. Now let's understand this little endian, big endian with the help of an example. So let's understand little endian format first. So this is my data that I have to store inside the memory. So this is my memory and this is my data. Now this data is in hexadecimal format. So this 0x is not the part of data, but it is telling me that this 4, 6, 2, 3, 7, 5, 8, 6 is my data in hexadecimal format. Now this data is stored inside this integer variable. Clear? Now, as you know that in hexadecimal number system, every 4 bits are treated as one number. So this 000 is 0, then this group of bits are treated as 1 and so on. And if you write 10, so let's say 8, 9, 10, this is in the binary. So this group of 4 bits will be written as A in hexadecimal number system. So if you do not know what is hexadecimal number system, then you can watch my one of my video, that is number systems. So in that I have told all the number system that are used in the computer science mostly. So this data has to be stored here. Now little endian format tells that the least significant byte of our data will be stored at the lowest address inside the memory. Now, as I told you, this is my data. So here this 6 is actually group of 4 bits and this 8 is group of 4 bits. Again, 5 is group of 4 bits and so on. So 4 bits plus 4 bits will be 8 bits and 8 bit means 1 byte. So this 8, 6 is actually telling me that it is 1 byte data. 1 byte data. Now 7, 5 is another byte, 2, 3 is another byte, and 4, 6 is the another byte. So this 8, 6 is the least significant byte, and this 4, 6, this is my most significant byte of my data. And here this is my memory. So in this memory, these are the addresses. So 100 is one of the address, then 101, 102, 3, 4. And each box or each cell of this memory contains 1 byte, and this is the lower address and this is the higher address. That means here it will be lower address and we will be moving here to here. So the address will go on increasing, 100, 101 and so on. So in this little endian format, my LSB will be stored at the lowest address. So let's say I want to store my data from 100 to 103. So this least significant byte 86, it will be stored at the smallest address or the lowest address. So in 100, 101, 102, 103, which is the lowest address? 100 is the lowest address. So 86 will come here and 86 will be stored here. After that, this next byte 75 will be stored at this address. Then 23, this next byte will be stored here. Then this 46 will be stored at this address. So in this arrangement, my data, this data will be stored in this memory. So this is little endian scheme or little endian format. Now let's come to big endian format. So this big endian is just opposite of little endian. So in little endian, the lowest byte, that is this 86, will be stored at the lowest address, that is 100. But in big endian format, at this lowest address, LSV will not be stored, but MSV will be stored at this lowest address. So I want to store, let's say, data from 100 to 103, because I have 4 bytes, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, this 46 is the MSV, 86 is the LSV. So at the lowest address, this MSV will be stored. Then next byte, that is this 23, will be stored at the next address. Then this 75 will be stored at here. Then my LSB will be stored at this address. So if you see, the arrangement of the data in little endian and big endian is different. In little endian, at the lower address, LSB is stored. In big endian, at the lower address, MSB, that is most significant byte, is stored. So if your CPU is little endian format based, then your data will be stored in such a way inside that memory in that laptop or desktop. Or if your CPU is big endian, then inside the memory in that computer, the data will be stored in this fashion. So this was storing the data inside the memory or writing the data inside the memory. Now if the CPU wants to read this data either in the big endian or the little endian, the data should be like this way only, that is this 4623 7586, and it should look like same in the little endian format also. So how CPU will read this data? Let's say we have little endian format. So first CPU will read this data, that is 46. So 46 will be stored. Then it will read this 102, that is data at 102 is 23. Then CPU will read data at this address. So data is 75, and then next byte will be stored, that is 86. So this will be the data that I will be getting, and this is same as the original data. In big endian, it will be opposite reading, that is first 46, that is first the lower address will be read. So 46, then 23, then 75, and then we will read 86. So again, this is the same data as was the original data. So as a user, you do not need to worry that how your data is going inside your memory, either in the little endian or big endian. It is the responsibility of the CPU that it should read the data in the correct order according to little endian or the big endian. Now let's say you have this data, that is 25034290, and this is 0x to denote hexadecimal number. So if you want to store this data inside this memory, then how it will be stored? So in little endian format, as you know, the LSB will be stored at the lowest address. So let's say I want to store the data from 96 to 99. So where my LSB, that is where my 90 will be stored, at 96 address or 99? So it will be stored at the lowest address. So 90 will be stored here. Then my 42, next byte, will be stored here. Then this 03, and then my last byte, that is MSV, will be stored. So in this way, the data can be stored in the little endian format. If same data has to be stored in the big endian format, then how it will be stored? It will be the opposite of this. So it will be like here 25 will come, that is MSV will be coming at the lowest address, then my 03, then my 42, and then my last byte, that is 90, will be stored here. And again, while reading, it is the same procedure as we have discussed. First, this 25 will be read, then 03, then 42, then 90. And in this big endian, first 25, then 03, then 42, and then 90 will be read. Now the question is there any CPU which is based on the little endian format or the big endian format? So yes, as you know, Intel is one of the CPU. So Intel is actually based on little endian format. So Intel is little endian based CPU. And for big endian, we have Motorola and we have Spark. These are some of the CPU which are based on the big endian format. Now next question that will be coming to your mind is, how does it matter, that is, whether my system is little endian or big endian from the perspective of hardware or the software? So from hardware point of view, it does not matter whether my system or the CPU is little endian or big endian. So CPU will just read the data from the memory and it will place inside its register. But from software point of view, it matters. And how does it matter? So before understanding this point, that how it matters from the software point of view, first let's see how we can detect or how we can check whether my system or the CPU is little endian or big endian with the help of a C program. So here it is my small C code and it can check whether my machine is little endian or big endian. So let's understand this program. So here I have taken a variable A having the value 1. So after this, I have taken a character pointer and I have used some explicit type casting, and this is address of A, that is variable A, and I am taking the address of A with some type casting. Then I am checking the condition on this star P. If this star P is equal 1, then CPU is little endian, else CPU is big endian. So let's understand it. So this is my binary conversion of 1. So this 1 is my decimal number. So this one is same this, and this is the binary format. So at last there is 1. These are 32 bits because my integer A variable will be of 4 bytes. Now we have to see how this data will be stored in the little endian or big endian format. So let's say first I tell you how it will be stored in the little endian format. Now let's convert this into hexadecimal format. So this can be read as 1. This can be written as 0. This group of 4 bits is 0. This is 0. And you know all the other bytes will be 000. Now in little endian, as you know, at the lowest address the LSB is stored. So least significant byte is this one. So this is group of 4 bits, 4 bit, that is total 1 byte. So 01, that is hexadecimal number 01, this byte will be stored here. And what will be stored here? The next byte is 00. What is the next byte? Again, as you know, all the bytes will be 000. So again 0000. So this is 1 byte, 2 byte, 3 byte, 4 byte. All the bytes are stored here. So this was the case of the little endian format. Now if same data is going inside the big endian format, then how it will be stored? So at the lowest address, MSB will be stored. So in this case, what is the MSB? So this is the MSB. So this is 0 and this group is also 0. So here it will be 00. Then next 00 will be coming. Then next 00 and last LSB is 01. So it will be stored here. So this is my big endian format based system or big endian CPU. So this is the storage of the data inside the memory. So let's say my system is little endian. So here I have taken a character pointer char star p, and now I am taking the address of A. So what is the address of A? So when I say address of A, so it will always be the smallest address. It does not depend on whether my machine is little endian or big endian. So address of A will be 100. So this is my address of A. And where I am storing this address of A? Inside P. So P will be storing, correct? So P will be storing 100. Now as you know, A is of type int. So address of A will be of type int star. And this P is of type char star. So type mismatch will occur. So for that, what we have done is we have typecasted this int star to char star. So this char star is used with the help of explicit typecasting. So now this line will work fine. Now this char star p can point to how much data? It can point to 1 byte data because p is a character pointer. So p will be actually pointing to this data, that is this 100 address. So if I see here star p equal 1. So what is the value of star p? So p has 100, and if I put star here, so I will be getting 01. So just 01 is this one. So if I convert this into decimal, what will be the answer? It will be 1. So this star p, yes, it is 1. 1 equal 1, yes, my CPU is little endian. So let's say if you are using Intel CPU, so in that case your answer will be your CPU is little endian. Let's say if your CPU is big endian, then what will happen? So p will be storing this 100 address. Clear? Okay, so this line will be same. Now here, what is the value of star p in case of big endian? So p is pointing to 100, but here 00 are stored, that means this MSP is stored. So here I will come and I will check star p. The value of star p is 00, that means this total is 0 in decimal. So this 0 is not equal to 1. So I will say my CPU is not little endian, it is big endian. Correct? So based on how the data are stored, I can detect whether my CPU is little endian or big endian. Here p was pointing to the LSP, and here p is actually pointing to the MSB. So let's run this program in our IDE. So this is the program that we have discussed, and in my system there is Intel CPU. So in my case, if I run this program, the answer will be CPU is little endian because Intel is little endian based CPU. So let's run it. So see, my answer is coming as CPU is little endian. So if this program is run on the Motorola or Spark, that is on any big endian CPU, then your answer will be CPU is big endian. And one thing to note here is you can take unsigned int also. So int A or unsigned int A, both will work. And another thing is you can take any other data also here, for example some 0x and then 56, 78, let's say 56, and then let's say 60. So with the help of this data also, you can check whether your CPU is little endian or big endian. How? Now in case of the little endian, so at the lowest address, what will be stored? The LSP, that is 60. So you can check if star p is pointing to this data, then your CPU is little endian. Otherwise, your CPU is big endian. So let's run it. Yes, your CPU is little endian and it is correct. And what will be the value of star p in case of big endian? It will be 56. So I hope you have understood that how we can detect whether our CPU is little endian or big endian. Now let's come to our last question, that how does it matter for a programmer to know whether his machine or the CPU is little endian or big endian? So from software point of view, there are two reasons actually. So first reason is whenever you are using pointers and the typecasting, then you should know that your CPU is little endian or big endian. Why? So in this example that we have discussed, so here we have used typecasting and pointer. So here character star p is pointing to the integer data, but we have said that please typecast it to char star. So now this p will be pointing to only 1 byte. So in case of little endian and big endian, my answer will be different for star p, because here star p is saying 1 and here star p is saying 0. So I can tell my correct answer only when I know that whether my CPU is little endian or big endian, and how the data is getting stored in case of both these little and big endian. But for this case, it will not matter whether your CPU is little endian or big endian. Inside x, you will get the same data. For example, in this character variable x, you are storing the data of a, and you have typecast it using char. So that means only 1 byte will be getting stored inside x from a. And what will be that 1 byte? So the LSB of the original data is copied inside x. So in this one, what is the LSP? This is the LSP. So this one will be copied inside x, or you can say in hexadecimal 01 will be copied. And in Big Endian also, the data is same. So only the LSB is this. So again, one will be stored inside X, either in Little Endian or Big Endian. So you should know that it matters in this case to know whether my CPU is Little Endian or Big Endian, but not in this case. So let's run it. So I have written the same example. I have taken character variable X and I'm storing the data of A inside this X. And then I have printed the X. So I just use here slash n. So let's run it. So see, my answer is coming as 1 for this X. And if your system is Big Endian, then also this X will give me 1. And this answer will be CPU is Big Endian. And one other place where this knowledge of Little Endian and Big Endian is important to know, that is whenever you are communicating between the devices. So for example, you have your laptop and let's say it is Little Endian based and data is coming from network. So let's say you have TCP IP protocol. Now TCP IP actually encode the message in form of Big Endian format, and that is standard. So TCP IP is encoding the message in Big Endian format, but your machine can understand Little Endian format. So here, this Big Endian data should be changed to Little Endian format before it is read by this laptop or this CPU. So this Big Endian has to be changed to Little Endian. So the program which is reading this data from the external source, it should have the functionality, or it should have some function which can convert this message, Big Endian message, into Little Endian message. And then your CPU will be reading this data. Otherwise, what will happen if you do not use this conversion scheme into your program, which is you are running here? So this Little Endian CPU will just read this Big Endian data as if it is in Little Endian format, and your output will come as incorrect. So here you should know that from where your data is coming, and if your data is coming from some another representation other than your original representation of your host CPU, then you need some conversion mechanism into your program, into your software. So one last thing that I want to tell you is Big Endian format or Big Endian scheme is also known as network byte order. And this Little Endian format is also known as host byte order. So I hope you have now understood what is Little Endian and Big Endian, and how does it matter from the software perspective and the hardware perspective. From the design of microprocessor, it does not matter, but from the software perspective, it matters to know the Little Endian and Big Endian formats. So in IoT or the embedded application where data is coming from the external sources many times, so this knowledge should be very critical to know. So that's all for this video. If you have any question, comment, query or suggestion, please put down into the comment box. If you like the video, please subscribe the channel and share this video also among your friends. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.